Good morning, students. In last class, we have discussed about Euclid's axioms and postulate. In today's class, based on that, we are going to solve examples. See here, the example number 1 tells us that if A, B and C are 3 points on a line and B lies between A and C, then prove that AB plus BC is equal to AC. Now see here, students, what they are telling is, here A, B, C are 3 points on this line, okay, and this B point lies between A and C. We have to prove here AB plus BC is equal to AC. Now see here, solution. See here in figure, okay, see in figure this AC, okay, AC coincides with what? This AC coincides with AB plus BC. Now we know that also Euclid's axiom says that, what it will say? Says that things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Yes or no? Things which coincide, things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Is this is correct? Now see here, this AC in the figure, you see this AC coincides with AB plus BC. We know from Euclid's axiom that things which will going to coincide, I told you that, I took one, the example, do you remember? See, these are the two things. If these two things coincide with one another, what we can tell? Things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Yes or no? Are equal to one another. Therefore, what we can say here? Hence, AB plus BC is equal to AC. Now see here. Second one. Prove that an equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. Now see here, students. We have to prove that an equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. Okay. So, what is an equilateral triangle? Equilateral triangle means what, students? Equilateral triangle is a triangle in which all sides are going to be equal. Okay. Now, we will construct, now we will show that an equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. See, what is a line segment? A line segment is nothing but a part of a line which has a fixed end point. Here AB is a line segment. Okay. Now see here. What I will do is, say using Euclid's postulate, what is that? Circle can be constructed, okay, on any point. Yes or no? With any point as a center. Yes. Now see here. What I will do is, with A as a center and AB as a radius. This is a Euclid's postulate, no? A circle can be drawn of any center of any radius. Yes or no? With A as a center and AB as a radius, just I will draw one here. Like this, a circle. Okay. Again, with B as a center and BA as a radius, I will draw here the one more circle. Okay, these two are going to meet at point C. Okay, now I will join this. Okay, I will join this line segment. Okay, now see here AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC because it is the radius of this circle. Okay, I am not drawn full circle. Here AB is equal to BC because this is the radius of this circle. What I can tell? Radii of the same circle. Okay. Now see, I will write AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. Okay. So this is what? AB is equal to AC because radius of this circle. Okay. Radii of the same circle. Now tell you, by seeing this two statements, what we are getting here? See, things which are equal to the same thing, things which are equal to the, these things which are equal to the same thing, what we can tell? These two are equal, yes or no? By using Euclid's axiom, things which are same to the, what is that? Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Yes, by using that axiom we can write here, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Now see, using Euclid's axiom, that is, things which are equal to same thing are equal to one another. Yes or no? Now see, these things are equal. Okay, here see, here AB. These things are equal to the same thing. What you can write? BC is equal to AC. Now see, that is, or we can write AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. Yes or no? AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. If AB is equal to BC is equal to AC, which triangle this is? Equilateral triangle. In equilateral triangle, all sides are going to be equal. So what we can write? So triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. Understood? Okay. This is about the second example. Now we will see the third example. Now see our third one. Distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. Now see, this is a theorem. Okay, we saw two examples. Now this third one is a theorem. Okay, example number 3 in your textbook, that is nothing but a theorem. Now see, two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. See, what they are telling is, two distinct lines, suppose this is line L1, okay, and this is line L2. So these two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. See, L1, L2. So these are the two distinct lines. Yes or no? it has only one point in common. We know that. We have to prove that two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. Two lines will have one point in common, no? This only we have to prove here. See, a solution given. What is given? Two distinct lines, L1 and L2. What is given? Two distinct lines, L1 and L2. Say, to prove, what we have to prove? To prove two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. This we have to prove here. Okay, two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. That is L1 and L2. The lines are L1 and L2. Now say proof. So we will assume that suppose line L1 and L2 have 2 points in common. We just are assuming, okay, 2 points in common. That is P and Q. See, we know that two lines will going to have 1 point in common. Okay, if these are the two lines will going to have 1 point in common. But we want to prove that line L1 and L2 have only 1 point in common. To prove this, what we are assuming? Suppose line L1 and L2 have 2 points in common, that is P and Q. Now see, then what we can tell here? Then line L1 contains points P and Q. Yes or no? See, we have assumed that L1 and L2 have 2 points in common, that is P and Q. What we can tell? Then line L1 contains point P and Q. Also, line L2 contains points P and Q. Yes or no? Line L1 will also contain point P and Q. Line L2 also contain point P and Q. So in overall, what we can tell that two line L1 and L2 passes through P and Q. From these two, what we can tell? Line L1 and L2, these two lines passes through 2 points P and Q. We will write that. So, two lines L1 and L2 pass through two distinct points. Distinct points P and Q. Now see, here students, we have learnt in Euclid's axiom. What is that? What we have learnt? In Euclid's axiom, we learnt that. Sorry, in Euclid's postulate, right? In Euclid's postulate, the first postulate, what it will tell? Say, from these 2 points, only one distinct line will pass. Yes or no? Postulate number 1 of Euclid's. What we have learned? If there are 2 points, okay, only one straight line can pass through the 2 distinct points. Yes? But here 2 lines are passing through 2 distinct points, P and Q. Yes or no? If there are two points, means only one line will going to be passed. Is there any possible to pass here one more line? No. But here two lines are passing, that is L1 or L2 are passing through P and Q. Is it possible? No. That's why what we can write. So our assumption was, okay, so our assumption was wrong. What is that assumption? That is two distinct lines. Two distinct lines, L1 and L2, have two common points, P and Q. Yes or no? So this was our assumption. Two distinct lines, L1 and L2, have two common points, P and Q. Our assumption was wrong. Yes or no? So therefore, what we can tell? Therefore, two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. Yes? Hence, two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. Yes? See, what we have written here? Two lines L1 and L2 pass through two distinct points P and Q. We have written this. Two lines L1 and L2 pass through two distinct points P and Q. So our assumption was wrong. Why this assumption was wrong means, according to Euclid's postulate, only from two distinct points only one line will going to pass. Okay, but here two lines are passing through point P and Q. This whatever we have written in assumption, this was wrong. Hence, two distinct lines cannot have more than one point in common. Okay, these are the worked examples of your textbook. Now we are going to solve few problems of the exercise part. Now see, exercise 2.1, they are told which of the following statements are true and which are false. Give reasons for your answer. We have to tell in these statements which statement are true and which statement are false, and we have to give reasons for this. Now see, only one line can pass through a single point. Is this true, students? Now see, first one, say a solution. Okay, see, only one line will pass through one point. From a single point, only one line will pass. Tell me, no. Infinite number of lines will going to pass through a single point. Yes or no? The first one is one false. Yes? Infinite number of line can pass through one single point. Okay? Now, this was the reason. What were to give reason? Infinite number of lines can pass through a single point. Now, there are infinite number of lines which pass through two distinct points. Now see, from two distinct points, how many lines we can draw, students? From two distinct points, we can draw only one line. Yes or no? But they are told that from these two distinct points, we can draw infinite number of lines. Is it correct? Say, these are the two distinct points. From these two distinct points, only one line we can draw. Yes or no? Then this statement is false or true? This statement will be false. So what is the reason? only two distinct points can pass through a given line. Through a given point. See, the first one we got false, and second also we got false. Yes or no? The in first question, the reason was infinite number of lines can pass through a given point. Okay? And in second one, what is the reason? From the given two distinct point, only one line can be drawn. Now see what third one, third statement tells us. A terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both the sides. Terminated line means line segment. What they are telling, in a line segment, we can produce, see, suppose this is a solution 3. What they are asking is, this is a line segment, yes, AB is a line segment. They are telling can be produced. Here line segment, according to Euclid, he will tell for line segment, terminated line. Can terminated line can be produced on both the side? Yes or no? Yes, it can be produced on both the side. A terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both the side? Yes, it is true. Third one is true. Okay? Terminated line can be produced from both the sides. Okay? The statement is true. Now we will see fourth one. Fourth one, see. If two circles are equal, then their radii are equal. Is it true? If two circles are equal. Okay? Suppose here, this is a circle, first circle, and this is a second circle. This is a second circle. Okay? What they are telling is, if these two circles are equal, then their radii are equal. Now see, this is a circle of radius R1 and this is a circle of radius R2. You just think it. Okay? See, suppose this area and this area are same. Okay, what is area formula? Area is pi R1 square. Here, area will be pi R2 square. Now see, if two circles are equal means what? If two circles are equal means what, student? Their area will be same. Yes or no? See, if two circles are equal means their area will going to be equal. What is the area formula? Pi r square. Here I took radius as R1. Pi R1 square. Here radius I took it as R2. It will be pi R2 square. Okay, now see. These two are equal. Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Yes or no? See, can I equate pi R1 square is equal to pi R2 square? Pi, pi get cancelled and squaring both sides, I am going to get R1 is equal to R2. Yes? See, R1 is equal to R2. What I can tell? If two circles are equal, then their radii are going to be equal. This is, the statement is true. Okay, fourth answer is true. Okay, now say fifth one. In figure AB, this AB is equal to PQ. This PQ is equal to XY. Then is AB is equal to XY? Is it possible? Now see, a student. Here they are given AB is equal to PQ. Okay? And XY is equal to PQ. Now see, this they are given. Things which are equal to the same thing. What we can tell? These are the things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. This implies AB is equal to XY. By using Euclid's axiom, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Yes or no? means this fifth statement is what? Fifth statement is true. Okay, this is about the first main. Now we are going to solve few more problems. Now see the fourth question. If a point C lies between two points A and B such that AC is equal to BC, then prove that AC is equal to half of AB. Explain by drawing the figure. See a solution. We will draw the figure. Okay. A, B. Now see, what are they given? If a point C lies between two points, say two points A and B is there, and a point C lies between A and B, such that AC is nothing but AC and BC are equal. We will show somewhere middle. Okay? See, here two points are there, A and B. Here C lies between the point A and B such that AC and BC are equal. Okay? Then prove that. We have to prove here. To prove what? AC is equal to half of AB. So this we have to prove here. Okay? Now say, what they are given here? Given AC is equal to BC. This they have given for us. We have to prove this. Now see a proof. So we will write the given thing. AC is equal to BC. This is given. Okay. Now what I will do? I will add AC on both sides. AC plus AC is equal to BC plus AC. What I done? Adding AC on both sides. Okay, now see, if equals, what see here, Euclid's axiom, things which are equal, these are equal. If equals are added to equals, the wholes are nothing but equal. Yes or no? That is nothing but what? Euclid's axiom. Okay, now see, AC plus AC, I can write it as 2AC. BC plus AC is here. This BC plus AC, what I can write, student? BC plus AC, I can write it as AB. Why? Because here AB is, you know, this AB coincides with AC plus BC. We know that things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Yes or no? Therefore, I have written here AB. So, from this what I can write? This implies AC is equal to half of AB. We got the result. Okay? See, why I have written here AB? Things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. Okay? Now, we will see the sixth one. In figure, if AC is equal to BD, then prove that, AB is equal to CD. So they are given the figure A, B, C. And this is D. Okay. In figure, if AC is equal to BD, here AC and BD are equal, then prove that AB is equal to CD. We have to prove. See a solution. So what is given? Given AB is equal to, given AC is equal to BD. What we have to prove? To prove AB is equal to CD. Now see a proof. Okay. So whatever they have given, we will write here AC is equal to BD. Now see, these are equal. Okay. If equals are subtracted from equal, what? The wholes are equal. This is the Euclid's axiom. Do you remember? Now see, I'm subtracting here. Now I'll subtract AC minus BC. I will subtract BC on both sides. BD minus BC. I will subtract BC on both sides. Okay? If equals are subtracted from, these are the equals. If equals are subtracted from equals, the wholes are equal. Yes or no? The remainders are equal, we can tell. Now see, what is AC minus BC? AC minus BC is nothing but AB is equal to. What is BD minus BC? See the figure. BD minus BC, it is CD. So this is our proof. Okay? So what we can write down? If equals are, these are the equals. If equals are subtracted from equal, the wholes are nothing but equal. Yes or no? Now see, AC minus BC, see the figure. AC minus BC is nothing but AB. BD minus BC. BD minus BC is nothing but CD. AB is equal to CD. Okay? See, only few problems I solved in exercise. Okay? The remaining you have to solve. Now we are going to see equivalent version of Euclid's fifth postulate. Now see, the next concept is equivalent version of Euclid's fifth postulate. So just remember, just revise what is Euclid's fifth postulate. What was that? See, suppose this is a line AB and this is a line CD. Okay, if these are two lines, these are the two lines. If a lines fall, if a line fall between these two lines, okay, what will happen here? These are nothing but interior angles. Yes or no? Angle 1, 2, 3, 4 are interior angles. Now see, if on any one side, if angle 1 plus angle 2 is less than 180 degree, means at that time, if you extend this, see, I will extend this by using a scale. If you extend these lines, if you extend these lines, it will going to meet at one point. Okay, what I want to tell is, if you take Euclid's fifth postulate, I am telling, here AB and CD are two lines and one line L, a line L is falling between these two lines. Okay, and here angle 1, 2, 3, 4 are what? Interior angles. If on any one side, this is one side, if the sum of these two angles, the sum of these two angles is less than 180 degree, means at that time, if we extend this, if we produce these lines, these two lines will going to intersect at one point. Okay, suppose if angle 3 and angle 4, suppose if angle 3 and angle 4 is less than 180 degree, means if we produce these two lines, it were going to meet at one point. Okay, now this is somewhat difficult to understand, Euclid's fifth postulate. Okay, it is somewhat tedious to understand. Now see, equivalent version is there for this postulate. So what is that? See, say Playfair axiom, equivalent, similar to this one axiom is there, that is Playfair axiom. Playfair, he is a Scottish mathematician, John Fair. Okay, John Fair is a Scottish mathematician. He has given this axiom, that is Playfair axiom. Okay, what it will tell, let's see. For every line L and for every point P not lying on L, there exists a unique line M passing through P and parallel to L. What is telling means? Suppose this is a given line, okay? For a given line L and for every point P, this is point P, this point P is not lying on this line, okay? This point P is not lying on this line L. For every line L and for every point P not lying on L. Now see, if you draw a line here, okay, from one single point we can draw so many lines, yes or no? If you go on drawing, okay, I will call this line as M. If from single point infinite number of lines we can draw. Now I have drawn so many lines. Now what we can tell? Only a unique line, okay, passing through P, the unique line M passing through P is parallel to the given line. Okay, see, that's why the exam is for every line L and for every point P not on L, there exists a unique line M passing through P and parallel to L. What it is telling? See, once more I will explain here. See, this is Playfair exam I am telling you. For a given line L, okay, and here point P is there, outside L point P is there. So from this point P we can draw so many lines, yes or no? We can draw infinite number of lines, but you will find out that only a unique line M which passes through P and parallel to L. All are passing through P, no problem. This is a unique line M which passes through point P and parallel to L. Okay, this is the equivalent version of Euclid's fifth postulate. Okay, this is about the equivalent version of Euclid's fifth postulate. Okay, now this can be also stated as, now see, this result can also be stated as, see here, two distinct intersecting lines cannot be parallel to the same line. Now see, this result can be also be stated as two distinct intersecting lines. Suppose here, suppose this is a given line, okay, here two intersecting lines are there. Think here, these are the two intersecting lines here. So these two intersecting lines cannot be parallel to the same line. So this can also be stated like this: two distinct intersecting lines cannot be parallel to the same thing. Okay, so what was the Playfair exam? For every line L and a point P outside L, okay, only a unique line M passes through P and which is parallel to the given line. Okay, this is the equivalent version of Euclid's fifth postulate. See, in Euclid's fifth postulate what we saw? If these are the two lines L1, L2, if one line M passes through this line, see, if any one side of pair of the sum of these angles are less than 180 degree, say if you produce this, it will going to intersect at one point. At that time what we can tell? If it is less than 180 degree, it will, these two lines are not parallel, we can tell that. Okay, if it is less than 180 degree or greater than 180 degree, it will won't be what? Parallel. Okay, only when it will be parallel means if the sum of the this angle 1 here, 2, 3, 4, okay, angle 1 plus angle 2, if it is 180 degree, and here angle 3 plus angle 4, if it is 180 degree, at that time only the two lines are going to be parallel. Okay, this is nothing but the Euclid's fifth postulate, but it is somewhat difficult to understand. Yes or no? But equivalent versions here, similar to that, what is that? For a given line L, a point P is there outside L. From that point P, a unique line M which passes through P, and this is parallel to L. This can also be stated as two distinct intersecting lines cannot have a same line which is parallel to that. See here. Now say this line is parallel to this line. Can I tell that this line is parallel to this? No. Only one line will be parallel to the given line here. If different intersecting lines are there, for all this intersecting line, this line will won't be parallel. Okay. This is about the what we are learning?